Now, the most obvious and most ancient way of making fire is obviously from other fire. Fires are actually quite common around here at a certain time of the year and in certain areas. The problem is the fire isn't always where you want it, so you need to find a way of transporting fire. Now, there's a couple of ways that early humans solved this problem, and a number of inventions that came into being, one of which I have in my hand right now. A stick. But not just any stick. If you look carefully, you'll see that this one is hollow. It's also very light. What it is it's something that's been lying around in the sun and the wind and the rain, and is essentially turned to sponge. Let's assume for a moment I'm Homo erectus. Not that there's anything wrong with that. And I come across a fire in my hunting gathering travels, and I want to take it back to my cave. Well, I poke my stick in it, and I get it going. Now that'll burn almost like a fuse or a wick for a very long time if I keep blowing on it. But I'm lazy and I don't want to keep blowing on it. So this is what I do. As long as I can keep oxygen flowing at the point there, this thing will smolder for probably a couple of hours.
Walking back to my cave, I'm walking back to my cave. Wave stick, wave.
Hello. And then the next part is pretty simple, but it takes a bit of practice. So, here we are, back at my cave. It's not much, but it's home. I have some tinder, some dry grass, in a coconut shell. Could just as well be a calabash, a gourd. I have some kindling and my magic fire stick. Behold, fire, which we will now celebrate with an ancient primitive ritual.
Boonga, boonga, oonga, boonga, oonga.
Arr, arr.